What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. It is Tuesday, March the 19th. Hope you guys are ready to check out my 2024 season setup. And forgive me for some of the audio and for the wind. I apologize in advance. So again, guys, if you're new to the channel, if you like what you see, leave me a positive comment. Hit that thumbs up. Hit that subscribe button. Both are free. So let's get to it, guys. Tune in, sit back, enjoy the lineup. What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. As you can see, this is going to be pretty self-explanatory. This is the Grant Sloan Care 2024 lineup. So to make this video just as short as possible, to keep everybody's attention span locked into the video, let's go ahead and jump right into it. We're going to start off with the truck. If you guys missed the truck story on how I ended up getting the truck that I'm in now, excuse me while I adjust the camera just a little bit. This is going to be raw in real time. So just forgive me as I just make just a little adjustment. But anyway, guys, go back and watch the video. I believe it's labeled "What 2023 Taught Me in Lawn Care," and you will figure out exactly, you know, what led up to the journey of me getting this truck, which is a 2016 Chevy Silverado 1500. It'll be a year in May since I got it. Awesome little work truck, two-door truck, very limited room, but I use it only for a work truck or if I have to haul off any junk or something like that. As you can see, got a pretty decent sized tail bed on it. Took just a little bit of the tail space off with the toolbox on it that I purchased, you know, to go along with the truck, because of course, you know, every work truck needs a toolbox. So anyway, 2016 Chevy Silverado, a year in May since I've had it. Love the truck. Only had a few repairs I've had done to it. If you look back in some of my videos, some do-it-yourself videos, you obviously see exactly what I had to repair, and I did it myself. Some of it I did have to get a little bit of help on. Far as the last thing I did was put on a serpentine belt, but far as putting on the thermostat sensor, and there was one more thing, I did it myself. So thanks to you guys on YouTube for the free knowledge. Let's jump right into it. The next thing you can see right here is my 5x8 trailer. Had that trailer ever since I went into the business, which will be, this should be my fourth year. Started in 2020 to be exactly, right shortly after COVID. I was, if you haven't been paying attention to, you know, things leading up to today, I have been cutting grass prior to COVID. As far as opening it up as a business of my own, you know, 2020 was my official start to saying, hey, I'm going to jump out here, I'm going to be an entrepreneur, and I'm going to jump to, you know, doing lawn care. So again, that's a 5x8 trailer. Had that trailer since I went into business. As you can see, it's a little bit of an older trailer. It's kind of, you know, seen some better days, but it gets the job done. It totes around everything that you see here on a daily basis as I need it. But you don't have to have a super large trailer. A lot of the trailers that I pass frequently, when I say frequently, there are a lot of people in the lawn care industry nowadays. You can't go no more than about a half a mile or even less than that without seeing another lawn care company with a small setup. I do have the racks on there. The cones are obviously sitting on top of the racks. The racks holding my trimmers. We just didn't get along, so I just removed my trimmers. I put them in the tail bay of my truck. So let's jump into the equipment. Without any particular order, I'm just go from front to back and we'll wrap this video up. My two gas cans, my mix can and my regular gas can. This is a 5 gallon can. This is a 2.5 gallon can. Again, I use that as my regular. This is my mix. No problems with them whatsoever. I was interested in a sure can. but I just didn't get one because I'm going to use what I have. You know, the price of gas cans, you think they'll sell gas in the cans with them, right? As expensive as they are. But anyway, let's hop to the next thing. You know, gas cans are self-explanatory. Trimmer line. As you guys know, I just was talking about my trimmer line. My go-to number one trimmer line, the Copperhead Vortex Professional 0.95 line. Hands down, at this point, my favorite line. Definitely would recommend it to anybody. Let's go to a backup line that I use. I don't really admire it quite as much as I do that. Like I say, favorite line, 0.95 heavy duty professional line. I used it. I don't think it is heavy duty as they're claiming, but hey, whatever. Backup line, especially if I have a little bit of work left to do. I have a couple pieces that is already broken down. If I don't want to use up as much of my good stuff, I'll break this out, put it in my trimmer. I'll go to work with it. Gets the job done. You're going to have to tap your head a little bit more because this is, to me, just not, you know, a very heavy duty, as they claim, line. So being that I'm over here, you guys, again, I'll keep saying it because it's never repetitive. If you've been with me, my steel weed trimmer, FS56RC, is pretty much a homeowner style trimmer. I've had that trimmer now going on 2 years. It ended up becoming my backup trimmer once I get over to the Red Max. I started having problems with the steel, a lot of vibration. I had it looked at by a small engine mechanic. You know, he told me about the grease and everything like that. Everything was actually normal. Just, you know, the trimmer, I guess, has that flaw. It's a backup trimmer. I don't use it every day. Every once in a while, when I want to give that a break, I'll mess with that steel. But other than that, you know, I can give you a couple of positives about it. It does have great power for it to be a homeowner's edition. Not super heavy, but you know, it has, I guess you can say, work withable weight. And you know, it is, I don't know what the price is now. Like I said, I've had it 2 years ago, and everybody know the price of everything is on the rise. So when I first got it, it was just a little over $100. You know, I got it from an actual dealer, so y'all can check into that. You know, it's a still pretty good product. Like I said, I would recommend it. Moving over here to the Red Max, I've had this Red Max here just about, I think this would be year number two with it as well. It is a commercial style Red Max. The last number is on, I think it's a Z, or CZ260TS. Commercial style weed trimmer, my first that I bought commercial style. I love it. Decent weight. The shaft is pretty long, you know. And as you can see on both of them, not to sound like a repeater, but my last couple videos, Dahmer's grip. Get you a Dahmer's grip on your lineup. I'm telling you guys, if you have back problems or your back or anything is hurting, you know, right now, if you don't have a Dahmer's grip, they will fix your posture and you will definitely, definitely love that you make this purchase. But anyway, back to the Red Max. Like I said, going on year number two with it. I love it. This is my main go-to trimmer. As you can see, I have not, I did have the head off on that one, the shield. I have not at all taken this one off even after I purchased it. I didn't take it off, I left it on there. And I'm pretty much, you know, a lot of guys have their pros and cons as to why they do and why they don't take them off. I'm just, you know, at this point, I'm using this how it is and, you know, it's not really hindering me. I do use that, like I said, that's my main trimmer line. I use it in there, so it kind of reduces the amount of times I have to tap because that's such a good line. And, you know, the only time I had to tap a lot on this is if I'm cutting like a fence line or just some heavy duty stuff that's, you know, really tearing into the line. Ended up getting this Red Max trimmer on a small sale day. I pulled up, the Red Max company truck was actually at that dealer. I walked in, told him what I was looking for. He told me how much it would have been. And hey, as you can see, it's been added to the list. I love it. I would recommend it. I would recommend all of this. So I won't have to repeat it. I would recommend all of this piece of equipment that I'm going over because it has worked for me. It definitely worked for me and made some good money for me. Toner oversight. Guys, I'm gonna be honest with you, just to speed it up, both these push mowers, they're rarely used. I don't have many properties at all that I have to push. Pretty much I only have one right now that I have to push, and the reason being is because they have a super wet spot in their front. front yard, and I can't put that on because it's going to leave bad tracks. And on that incline, I don't want it to also slide and mess up the yard any worse. But anyway, this Toro Recycler, I bought this a little over, I think, a year and a half, 2 years ago now. Matter of fact, I think I bought this before I got that. Great little Toro Recycler. I liked it. It's a 22-inch. It's self-propelled, and you know, it gets the job done. The prices of them now, I think, are anywhere in the maybe $500-$600. I don't know. Like I said, the price of everything is up. Red Max Blower, EPZ $8,550. The Boneyard Lawn Service and Joe, I think it's Joe's Lawn Care. He's a big fan of, both of them are big fans of Red Max, so let me just say it like that. But Joe, he's always on my Instagram and whatnot. Those two guys turned me towards the Red Max when I was in the process of upgrading to a commercial style blower. Guys, great power, does great work. I'll bring this out for my commercial route. I do use this on some residential, especially during the leaf season or early spring cleanups. That's what I grab. That's what I've been using so far this season, just because I'm just re-entering all of the properties. Guys, this is a great purchase for me. I kid you not. I definitely, it was between this and a Steel. You know, there are other brands out there, but my eyes were on this or a Steel. I went for Red Max, even though Red Max and Husqvarna, which you see here in a second, same parent company, pretty much. I'm glad I made this purchase. Two cycle engine. Pretty good size gas tank, get a good bit of property done. Just depends on how hard you're running it with that gas tank. My Steel handheld BG86, the first blower that I purchased when I went into lawn care. Great, great, great lightweight blower. In and out. You don't have to try to throw it on your back and adjust your scraps and everything like that. This bad boy right here comes with me on my smaller properties. Those in and out properties, I cut, I mow, pretty much, weedy, blow, and I'm out of there. This right here, I would consider grab and go. You pull it, it starts, you go around the property, clean it up, what you gotta do with it. It ain't let me down yet. It cranks, no problems with it since I purchased it. Like I say, very first blower that I purchased when I went into business. Guys, this is the bread and butter right here. Bread and butter. Skag 48-inch Liberty Z. This mower right now, real time, has 375.9 hours, which is about to go over to 376 hours. Kept the maintenance up on it. Had just a few minor hiccups when I first purchased it, but the company, it was something on the company's behalf. They took care of it. Kept the oil change, kept everything greased. Love this mower. It is just a below the commercial style mower. It has a Kawasaki FR61V engine in it. I can't remember the horsepower right off the top of my head. Guys, great mower. It gets me through just about every gate and property that I have. Some of it, I don't really have a whole lot of space to get in and out, but guys, this mower has definitely been a champion for me. I can all in all say, honestly, I think I won't purchase nothing but Skags in the future. The only thing that I can think of that I may go over to if I change would be a Toro, but that's just in the future. That's nothing I'm planning right as of yet. But guys, great Skag mower. This mower is going on 5 years old with me, 4 years in the business. The mower that I first started off with, I have a short clip that'll be at the end of this video. It was a yard machine tractor. It's down pretty much, but you'll see that at the very end of this video. Guys, we'll go over to the last two pieces of equipment. This is my Husky backpack blower. It's a 150 BT. They do have just a little bit newer model of this backpack blower. Excellent mid-level blower, backpack blower, great power. I can about compare it to this, only it's just a backpack blower. But this is my second blower. That Red Max is my last blower, my third blower that I picked up. I picked this up from a family that was moving. They sold it to me for a good price. Great blower, for medium-sized jobs. But like I said, all of this stuff right here, Floors wise, you know, for me, small jobs, medium jobs, big jobs. I usually take this out on my medium-sized yard residential routes. You know, that's usually my second day of cutting. I'll leave that at home, grab this, you know, crank it up, load the property, and I'm out the way. So, great pickup. You know, I think this is out of Lowe's. I'll pick that up in a minute. You can get these out of Lowe's, and you can also pick them up from a dealer. I know a lot of people recommend getting a lot of your equipment from a dealer, and I totally can agree with them. Stuff in the big box stores, that stuff can work, absolutely. But going to a dealer, I think you just got that little bit more support when it comes to having to get repairs done, or, you know, even if you're like me and try to fix some things on your own, you know, you can go to that dealer and they can easily go there and, if it's in stock, give you what you need and you're out the door. You know, you go to these big box stores, you know, they got a lot of stuff that ain't stocked yet, things that they just ain't even, you know, thought about ordering yet. And, you know, we, at this time of the season, we're rocking and rolling. We don't really have a whole lot of time in between waiting on parts. But you can get this, like I said, from dealers or Lowe's. I got this one from a dealer. I got that one from a dealer. And I picked this one up from a family that was there. Guys, the last piece of equipment that I picked up last year, this Craftsman 140cc front wheel drive self-propelled mower. This is my mower that I use on that one property that I was telling you guys about when it comes to the water settling in the yard. Easy pickup. I actually got this from my mom. Great little lawnmower. Like I said, it makes me, you know, go across that property with ease. That mower and that mower, both of them come with the bags, but I just had really no use to use the bagging system on them. You know, I just mulch everything up and keep it moving. But guys, the last thing I'm going to say before I wrap this video up, as you can see, I have a 5x8 trailer and, you know, the tailgate of a truck. I absolutely do not, and I hope the wind isn't interfering with the audio, I absolutely do not take all of this stuff with me when I'm out doing properties. I just have, even if I had a big enough setup to do it, I have no desire to take all of this stuff with me on my routes. Number one, I'm not going to use it all. Number two, it definitely draws attention to your vehicle for people that are in the thief business. Theft is at an all-time high. Again, shout out to Drake's Lawn Care and the Lawn Bay. If you follow them on YouTube, even with Curtis, Curtis from Curtis Lawn Care, back in last year, they both took major hits from people stealing their equipment. They stole Curtis's trailer. They stole Drake's Lawn Care and the Lawn Bays. They stole all of their equipment. And guys, if you have all of this stuff on your truck, especially with an open trailer as me, and you don't really have, you know, the total amount of, you know, security thing as far as, you know, like I'm having a brain lapse right now on exactly what, I think it's called the Sure Rack or something like that. But anyway, if you don't have the proper stuff to lock this stuff down, it will take somebody just a second to get rid of your stuff off of your stuff and put it in their vehicle and they're gone. So I only take what you see here. I only take what I need on my routes. I know where I'm going. I know what my route is going to require for the specific date. So all of this stuff, when I'm not using it, it's home, it's locked up, it's secured. I only take what I need for what particular day. I know on my commercial days, I'm going to have my big blower. I know, like I said, my medium days, I'm going to have that blower. And on my small days, I'm going to have my small handheld. I'm always going to have my trimmer. I don't always even take my gas can. The only can that I take frequently the most is my mixed gas. But other than that, that tank on that lawnmower is a 5 gallon tank. I can get through a lot of properties on that tank. I leave the gas can at home, other than unless it's a day I have to take it and fill it up. But guys, that's my 2024 setup. I hope you guys made it this far in the video. Please, if you're new to the channel, if you enjoy what you see, go back and check out some of my other videos. Like the videos, subscribe to the channel if you like what you see. Leave some positive comments down below. Guys, this makes 2024 very prosperous. It's not starting off exactly how I wanted to, because, you know, you're going into the season with either losing some clients that comes with the territory, and or it just comes with, you know, the season starting off a little bit slower because, you know, we're still technically we're in spring, but today it's only in the maybe the the high 50s. It's kind of cool outside. As you can see, I have on a hoodie and a beanie. But guys, this is my setup. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And if you, again, please leave me a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel if you're a returning viewer and you're entertained by what you see on the channel. It costs you absolutely nothing. Guys, I'm out of here. Y'all be safe. This is Simon from Grant's Lawn Care. I'll catch y'all on the next one. And guys, one more thing that I keep on my fleet. As you can see, I got my mower on this ramp. I have two of these ramps. I have one exactly like this one on the back of my truck. And the reason being, you see how convenient it makes it. Let's just say, for example, you end up running over a chain or a water hose or extension cord or something that you didn't see on the property. And you know, you can't get your deck to go up but so high in the air when you're out mowing a property. So you need to get to where you can get the mower up in the air and actually do the work on it to either take the blades off to get whatever's wrapped up under the deck, you know, from up under there. So that's another thing that's in my fleet for my 2024 season, is I'm gonna permanently keep a ramp. I got two of them just like that for purposes of if I hit something in a yard and I need to get up on my trailer, take the blades off, unravel whatever it is, and get back into the field. You know, less time, you know, trying to fight that stuff with the mower being flat on the ground versus I can drive it up on this ramp. Boom, boom, three bolts. Boom, boom, put them back on and I'm done. So that's it, guys. Thank you all for watching. Simon from Grant's Lawn Care. Peace out.